Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on fault code P0016, symptoms, causes, and fixes. P0016 fault code comes with the text camshaft, crankshaft, position correlation. And essentially that means that the timing of the crankshaft and camshaft are out of sync. Now it doesn't mean that they necessarily are out of sync. However, it means that the ECU is at least detecting or thinking that the two are out of sync. So quite a few different things can trigger fault code P0016. So with that said, let's just go ahead and jump straight in and discuss some of the most common causes of the crankshaft, camshaft, position correlation. One of the most common causes is a stretched or faulty timing chain or timing belt. The timing chain and timing belt are driven by the crankshaft and essentially determine the timing of the camshafts relative to the position of the crankshaft. So ultimately the timing belt or timing chain, depending on the engine, is responsible for keeping all of that timing in sync. So any issues there, whether again the belt or chain be stretched or it slipped or jumped a couple teeth, can certainly cause P0016, as that may allow the timing of the crankshaft and camshaft to come out of sync. Moving on to common cause number two, we have crankshaft or camshaft position sensors. Now, as the name suggests for these two sensors, they're responsible for monitoring the position of their respective components. So the crankshaft position sensor measures the position of the crankshaft, whereas the cam position sensor measures the position of the camshafts. So ultimately, an issue with either one of these sensors can cause fault code P0016. And these are certainly two of the most common causes of this fault code, as they're both sensors, both electrical parts that are prone to wearing down and simply degrading and failing over time. Moving on to our third common cause, we have issues with the timing chain or timing belt guides or tensioners. So the guides and tensioners on the timing chain or timing belt are responsible for keeping the chain or belt in place and synced up with the appropriate teeth in the right location. And so ultimately over time, if those guides or tensioners wear down, they may allow that timing chain to actually start slipping a little bit or jumping, skipping a couple teeth. And ultimately, much like issues with the timing chain or belt itself, these can certainly trigger the fault code P0016 and indicate that you have an issue with your crankshaft and camshaft timing. Our fourth and final common cause are issues with variable valve timing systems. So not every engine has a variable valve timing or VVT system. However, it's very common on modern cars, especially in the 2000s, and even more so for 2010 plus engines. A lot of vehicles now use variable valve timing. This allows essentially the camshafts to change timing to allow for a more fuel efficient, lower emissions, and better performance for the vehicle. So any issues with the variable valve timing system could potentially throw the timing of the intake and exhaust valves out of sync, which will ultimately lead to the crankshaft camshaft position correlation. Now, as I mentioned towards the start of the video, there are a lot of potential causes of P0016. Really only looked at four of the most common causes of this fault code. However, there are a couple other issues that may also trigger this fault code that are less common. Some of those include the PCM or ECU itself. If there are any issues with the engine control unit, that could trigger P0016, as well as any electrical or wiring problems. So again, the camshaft and crankshaft position sensors, as well as the variable valve timing sensors or any kind of solenoids, are all electronically controlled and have wiring. So any sort of electrical issue going to any of the sensors or wiring issues can also trigger this fault code. And then last, we have the camshaft or crankshaft reluctor wheels. Another thing that's a little bit less common, but if you have issues there, could certainly trigger P0016. Now, with the common causes of P0016 out of the way, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common symptoms of this fault code. When it comes to symptoms of P0016, there are a lot of different causes, and the exact symptoms can really vary depending on the specific cause of the fault code. So for example, if you have a serious issue with the timing chain stretching, those could be very different symptoms from an issue with the camshaft or crankshaft position sensor. But there are a few symptoms that are generally shared among any of these causes of code P0016. So number one on the list, we have the check engine light. This is the most obvious and basic one. If the engine is triggering fault code P0016, it will store it in the ECU. And ultimately, most fault codes, including P0016, when they're stored in the ECU, will then trigger the check engine light. So that's going to be the number one most common sign and symptom. Symptom number two is the vehicle cranking, but not actually starting. A few of the most common causes for cranking and not starting are issues with the camshaft, crankshaft position sensors, as well as potentially issues with the variable valve timing system or the solenoids or sensors for the VVT system. Anything with timing chain components can also cause the engine to crank but not start. And that's the case if you have a stretched timing chain or one that jumps a couple teeth or a broken timing chain guide or tensioner that just allows the chain to move a little bit. And again, that can throw the timing completely out of sync for the crankshaft and camshafts. And so ultimately, if that timing is thrown out of sync, it may be bad enough that the vehicle will crank but can't actually turn over because it's not getting the proper amount of air and fuel at the proper times in the cylinders. Tying into that, also kind of talking about the same symptom here, if issues are severe enough and the engine is cranking but not starting, this could also mean that your belt has completely snapped or that your timing chain jumped excessively and timing is so far out of whack that the vehicle will not start. And depending on the severity, it may not even crank. Moving on to another common sign and symptom, we have misfires, rough idle, stuttering, and overall poor performance. So lumping a few things together here, but ultimately, a lot of these causes of P0016, if the vehicle does manage to actually crank and turn over and start running, a lot of these will cause the vehicle to run poorly due to timing being out of sync. Moving on to our fourth and final common symptom, we have other random, miscellaneous, very fluky symptoms. So depending on the exact failure, sometimes some vehicles will have very weird fail safes depending on what issue is going on. We have a BMW that ran into a crankshaft position sensor failure a couple years back, and the vehicle would crank and turn over. It would take a while to crank. It would crank for about 5 to 10 seconds and then eventually turn over. However, once you actually put the BMW in drive, it would stay in third gear and refuse to shift out of third gear. And that's one of those things. The engine was essentially doing that to protect itself to get a better gauge of the location of the crankshaft. And so the same thing can happen with something like a camshaft position sensor failure. And this isn't a symptom that's going to happen on every vehicle, but just an example of some of these kind of weird fluky symptoms that you can run into, again, just based on fail safes and what the vehicle manufacturer has designed into it. With symptoms of P0016 out of the way, it's time to talk a little bit about diagnostics and repairs. So run through a couple quick general diagnostic and repair tips. Number one, always start with the basics. The best first bet is if you're able to pull fault code P0016, at this point, you've been able to read all of the codes stored within the ECU. A lot of the times there will be other fault codes associated with this. So for example, if you're getting P0016 alongside a variable valve timing related code, then that will point you in the right direction and indicate a likely issue with something VVT related, whether that be the sensors, solenoids, or something else with the VVT system. So that can help narrow things down and point you in the right direction. Number two, start with the simplest things to diagnose and double check. If you can easily locate and see the sensors in your vehicle, the crankshaft and camshaft position sensors, look in the general area, see if there are any damaged wires, loose connections, if the sensor looks like it's maybe gunked up or has oil or other fluids potentially dripping onto it. A lot of the times with this fault code, you'll again either have additional fault codes that can point you in the right direction, or you'll notice something clearly wrong with the vehicle if you are able to inspect some of those components that may be visible, such as again those sensors, any sort of wiring running to the sensors, so on so forth. So just start with the basics and see if you can narrow it down from there. Now, most vehicles, inspecting the timing chain and timing belt is going to be hard. They're often not visible or easily visible, but if you do have access to that and can see it easily or remove a couple components to easily see the timing chain, guides, tensioners, etc., then that's a good next step, is inspecting that area, seeing if anything is visibly off with the timing chain or belt or guides. If you don't find anything visibly wrong, then it is going to require some more advanced diagnostics. So if you're not an experienced mechanic or DIYer, then that might be a good time to take the vehicle into a shop to get the fault code P0016 properly diagnosed. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more. Thanks, everyone.